Hey YouTube, Zach Columbus here, welcome to another video. Every now and then I'll get commentary with regards to my confirmed flag videos. Namely, the negative comments, and this is what I'd like to address. Because many people who basically say, listen, because you condone the confirmed flag, automatically, guess what? You're a racist. You're a bigot. You condone slavery. You condone every evil aspect of the dark time of this country. And to which I would respond very, very faithfully and honestly, listen, slavery is still ongoing. It's still supported by, guess what, the United States flag. And every time you go out and buy a shirt, a TV, toys for your children, gasoline, and the likes are up. And of course, people will say very blatantly, but you're comparing apples and oranges, and to which I respond, really? Let's look at how your shirt was made, under what conditions they were made, what wages the individuals that made the shirt, what wages they were given. And again, people dismiss it. They really do, and it's very, very surprising. But one of the most interesting comments that I get is, you know, what about the Cornerstone speech? What about the Confederate Constitution? They openly condoned slavery. The Cornerstone speech says very blatantly that the foundations of government are built upon slavery. Again, that's from Alexander Stevens, the Vice President of the Confederate States. To which I would respond as well, but look at what our political leadership were saying at the time. Look at the laws that were passed against black people in the North as well. For example, that it was illegal for slaves to stay in their states for more than 30 days. Again, you know, people don't look at those little facts. And one of the most interesting facts that I'd like to bring up, and this is a very interesting quote that I'm about to read, I'd like for you to judge for yourselves, you know, who's the racist and all that. This is from the great emancipator Abraham Lincoln. The guy, the president, who, by the way, disregarded probably almost every aspect of the Constitution, not just in the spirit, but in the letter of the Constitution, the letter of the law. This is what Abraham Lincoln had to say in 1858 of September in Charleston, Illinois, during the Lincoln-Douglas debates. And again, this is coming from a former President of the United States, who, by the way, was elected by the Northern states, practically. And to which I quote, "I will say then that I am not, nor have ever been in favor of bringing about in any way the social and political equality of the white and black races. That I am not, nor have ever been, in favor of making voters or jurors of Negroes, nor of qualifying them to hold office, not to intermarry with white people. And I will say, in addition to this, that there is a physical difference between the white and black races, which I believe will forever forbid the two races living together on terms of social and political equality, and insomuch as they cannot so live, while they do remain together, there must be the position of superior and inferior, and I, as much as any other man, am in favor of having the superior position. The Negro should be denied everything." End quote. That was from Abraham Lincoln, the 16th President of the United States. So to my detractors out there, I would ask you, is that racist? Peace.